Oh, God, I gotta go work again. Son of a... Oh, wait. I'm in an anime.
Well, for a moment, I thought it was 3:30 in the morning for me, where I always have to wake up.
It seems like I'm going to be one of the... From what I hear, I'm probably going to more likely be one of the people up front at Black Friday.
I know that feel, bro. In fact, there are some days I'm not even working on Black Friday. I'm working on Thanksgiving to the start of Black Friday.
Oh, that's even worse.
Yeah. Yeah, it is.
Though I had to laugh at the fact that somebody referred to that as Brown Thursday. I'm like, that's all. That's going to be brown at the end of it.
At this point, they might as well call it Black Thursday, because it's already been burnt to a crisp.
Well, let's see. Last time, Emmy decided to go run in the rain.
Yeah, long story short, even if you have a good immune system, not a very bright idea.
I do it all the time, and my immune system is our shit, and I don't get that sick from it. Dude. Love is like a river, peaceful and sweet. Your soul is like a secret I could never keep. Oh, there's a secret that won't be kept here.
you seem to be perfectly healthy. I'm currently having heart problems. How could you say I'm healthy?
Oh, I wasn't talking about you. I was talking about me. Look at this black shirt. I spent $3 on it.
Seriously, do you know how long it took for me to get rid of that bulge in my gut?
And look at that.
You like, honestly don't want to know.
And I spent $200 on this belt buckle. Best investment ever, Hisao. You gotta understand, the comfort of a good belt buckle. Yeah. It's not a Velcro one like that pussy Mobius wears all the time. I mean, come on.
Yeah. Or that plain white tee with some grease stains on it that one fucking Eizen dude wears. I mean, seriously, have you seen that shit? Awful. Just awful.
Yeah, you do. I know what pills you take.
No, seriously, I know what you take. All it takes is just one change, and I can easily end your miserable, pathetic life.
Or even better yet, I can make you change genders.
Oh, so now he's gonna suffer from gynecomastia?
Sure, why not? Well, I guess he's out starting a lawsuit.
Yep. But look at the bright side, Hisao. When you do suffer from gynecomastia, at least you'll suddenly have a cute little nickname, He-Booby.
Unless they go the extra distance and go for the actual sexual reassignment surgery.
In which case, you'll change your name from Hisao to Ranma.
Let me think here. What would be more feminized version of Hisao's name?
Huge Tenshi fan / magical girl reporter Sammy, Misao? We can always go with that.
I think that'd actually work, actually.
Yeah. It's official. Your new name is Misao Nakai.
And now this game has turned into a Yuri game. Which means it is now the best game ever.
Unless, of course, into Yaoi, in which case, I'm terribly sorry we've ruined your fun.
In that case, we'll just do the same thing with Hatoful Boyfriend, then we'll... then we'll totally destroy the whole point of that altogether.
Although, would that technically be considered Yaoi or furry Yaoi? Because I know I only saw bits and pieces of it when Proton John was streaming that bit. It's like, yeah, once you meet the new characters, you get to see what they look like humanized, but otherwise it's mostly just birds. Nothing but birds.
Well, you just gotta think of yourself as a bird. Just don't get to the point of like, the fuck the bird.
Knowing me, I'd probably be the god pigeon, only not that awesome. if I was to take the form of a bird right now.
Hey!
Oh, hey!
Hello, seen
Lily.
You in a while.
Long time no see.
Yeah, because you've been doing.
We agree. Yeah, very busy taking jogs with Emmy, nearly killing yourself while running. Yeah, you could say pretty much
well,
busy.
Well, by this point, it's not doing him as much harm as it was before. At this point, his heart is kind of actually adjusting to it.
Yeah.
Though, speaking of adjustment, let's just say the next... if you're... How should I say... how should I say, fearful of the female form or some acts of sexual activity, the next act will not be for you.
No.
Though there are going to be some hilarious moments that I think people have had happen a few times in their own life, so be sure to watch that. Hey, you might learn some actual biology.
I'm just going to warn those who are expecting to see slightly edited stuff when it comes to censorship. I know nothing about Photoshop, so unless I can get someone who can help me with that, I'm most likely going to cut those scenes all together and just put in like a black screen title card.
Or, actually better yet, I think the best that you could probably do is create like a black outlining in like I think Vegas 9 or something like that, or just use that and then just put it over like, you know, the 9 bits as it were. Even though mostly let's just say that with we'll only probably at best show one shot from one, and well, I don't know, it's all up to Eizen, but mostly we just gotta have a shot of just basically Emmy's face during a certain point.
Yeah.
Which truly rings, what the fuck? But...
Not just what the fuck were you thinking, but rather, what the fuck was I thinking?
As long as I think you have the age restrictions, I think you could probably still pull it off. Because
yeah.
I do know that some people...
I think
some people have
non-commentary version, it's going to go up uncensored regardless, but... Yeah.
Unless we want to actually take the censored version of that part of the game. But then again, you already record it, so...
Yeah. But that's just it. I need to find a way how to block out nipples as well. Because, you know, for kids edition.
That's a Sensei Eizen. Warning you about
apparently it's like NBC, only in this case it's the more you don't know.
Yeah, you might as well just knock anyway.
Mm-hmm.
If you're just going to stand in there like a dope, you're just going to look like a creeper.
Just a little. And this is probably one of the very few times you ever see Emmy without her twin tails.
Honestly, I think she looks better without those twin tails, honestly.
Yeah.
But... to be fair, I think it's kind of her kind of trying to play the innocent part in a way.
Mm-hmm.
And she's a little more than that.
Mm-hmm.
Fuck, I can't stop blushing. This ain't helping! I have problems.
And boom, I suddenly have twin tails again.
Lazy sons of bitches!
Now, seriously, this is one of those few times where just a little bit of custom work would have helped. Like what you mentioned earlier back at the track meet, where even if they showed a clip of Hisao's jacket on her, this one too, without the twin tails, you know.
Even though the thing is, there, if I recall, there is kind of the sprite for it, or the picture for it, so it's like...
Ha ha ha.
Why are you paying attention to her shirt?
Yeah, why would you? Plus, if memory serves, and we've suddenly gone Batman here. And by Batman, I mean the campy 60s Batman.
Of course.
The Adam West one. So, have you confessed to her yet? No? Then this is probably an awkward position you should be in.
Why aren't you guys fucking already? Jesus Christ!
Misha, I thought you were in a different part of the dorm. No! I was here this whole time! I'm practically living in the closet here!
Well, it's about time that you came out! Well, that shit not funny! That shit not funny!
That's why I'm gonna give you a Batman-style wham! Here comes... BAM!
I actually had this with fucking Kuiper Camp 2, bitches!
Where's your Hyper Beam now?
Where's the Hyper Camp... Unregistered Hyper Camp 2 gun now, you stupid crack horse? And then Shizune's just sitting there silent and just slowly firing a red laser beam into the corner of the wall. Somewhere along the line, a Metroid got blown to bits. The captain.
I was going to say, if we wanted to make things interesting, just throw in Kenji in there. But then again, he's not fully blind, only partially blind, so I don't think he could get away with that.
But if anyone could fit the role of Kraid, he would.
Oh god, yes, he would. He so would.
So how was my day? Well, and then I went to the library, talked to Lily, and this whole time I was going through it all, while, you know, talking to you on top of you. Yeah, that was pretty boring, too.
That's pretty much the whole story of my life.
And somehow she got her pigtails back on. Did she put them back on? Writer, did you forget something? Alright, you gotta go back and you gotta rewrite this shit. You missed a line.
Sorry, that was my fault!
This is gonna play a big part in her route.
Heavily.
Huh? What? Why are you in bed with me?
The fuck were you doing in my bed?
Well, I was telling you about school and stuff, and you just kind of conked out, like pretty much every other friend I used to have. Or, well, every other friend that I did that to while I was in the hospital, but hey.
And perfect. I guess I could have just sat in a chair and walked out myself, but you kind of had a tight grip on my shirt, so yeah, there we are then. Just imagine next day in class. I told you he would sleep with her! You'll be 50 yen!
I still didn't lose your virginity yet! God damn it! This is a goddamn hero game! Why aren't you doing it yet? Jesus Christ!
Come on, Hisao! You're supposed to be a growing man! Grow some balls already!
But I am! The pills!
It's not my fault! It's the damn pills! The pills!
Yeah, but those people are mostly acquaintances.
Mm-hmm.
Well, on the plus side, Hisao did not take advantage of her while she was asleep. So, good on him.
Good for you. You earned some gentleman points.
You have the moral high ground. I have the high ground!
It's over, Anakin! I've got the high ground! Which apparently I've seen that Mythbusters episode. Apparently that's not true.
No, especially...
You might have a slight advantage if you have the higher ground, but otherwise it's not a huge advantage.
Well, the other thing is the fact that Obi-Wan actually kind of broke that rule in the first movie, so...
There you go. Plot inconsistencies. Where would we be without them?
Okay, if he was so interested in her well-being, he would actually have been there instead. And that would be incredibly awkward. Knowing me, I would have been like, abandon ship! Abandon ship!
Abort! Abort! Abort!
Cease operations! Now, do I become friend or lover?
Ooh, the troublesome theme is kicking in.
Well,
not just back to status quo, but just end the episode. Just cut it right there.
Alright, see you guys next time for actually...
Yeah, see you for the next episode of Katawa Shoujo.
You should have been paying more attention to what Ren was saying. Both of you. Usually when this song plays, it's usually when things are at a low point.
And usually in these situations, if a decision is being made, it's usually a make-or-break moment.
Yep. But thankfully, there isn't much decisions really in Act 2, for the most part.
Not really.
If at all. Are the go in running fact, or don't go running? There's really no penalty for that one, really.
Yeah.
It's Act 3 and 4 that will butt your balls!
I was going to say, if memory serves, it's like the end of Act 3, if not Act 4, where the real decisions for good and bad ending kick in.
Though, the thing is, there is a giant hint that you're actually given by, oddly, our teacher.
Mm-hmm.
Which is... When it comes to dealing with Emmy, know about the problem, but let her deal with it on her own terms.
Mm-hmm.
Don't force it.
Yeah.
Because otherwise, well, bad end.
Mm-hmm.
I need more coffee. I said, why are you making me a cunt, damn it? You're fired!
A cup of goddamn good coffee!
Somehow, if I actually did walk into the same coffee joint, I could just see you about to stab the cup.
if you ordered in and was at the pickup table, yeah, you probably would have seen me in drive-thru. Oh yeah, did I happen to mention the Dunkin' I'm working at as a drive-thru? Because, oh, there you go.
Oh god. That's even worse.
You'd think, but if you're just working the coffees, it's not that bad.
I'm just thinking of how fast that place fucking
and
runs.
Everything else, that's, yeah.
There's more to that statement than meets the eye.
Just a little.
She has such simple logic to it. It's kind of disturbing. Let me think. Dude, your conversation is very forced to a degree. Just ask a little, and if she just says, I don't really want to talk about it,
then don't go any farther. Let it be. Just let it be. Don't just push it.
Okay.
Because after all, Emmy's known for being a runner. Push her too much, she's just going to end up running.
Yeah. At the speed of sound.
I don't even think it's possible for even the best Olympic athletes. But if it were, who knows? Maybe even faster than the speed of light. Highly doubt it.
Huh. Well, there was, if I recall, I think there was a Matrix story in the Animatrix.
Oh, yes! Yes, I remember that one. Apparently ran so fast he saw visions of what no one else thought could be possible.
Albeit in the end, he basically ends up in a coma, to an extent.
I don't know if he went to a coma, but he did injure his legs to the point he's in a wheelchair and pretty much can't stand up. As far as the ending goes, if you haven't seen it, I won't spoil it. Even though I kind of technically did, but...
Yeah. I mean, I didn't notice that before. I mean, she does wear the outfit and stuff. I just figured that she's wearing that to give me a look at her butt. But, okay. I didn't know. Sorry. Wait, are you actually a doctor?
Oh my god. It's like he's actually doing his job.
Holy shit.
Kudos to you, insert name here, nurse.
So, okay, then. So, in that case, is the nurse the Omega Pirate then, or something? I don't know. No, the nurse is Adam fucking Malkovich.
I'm not gonna say it, but let's just say, come Act 3, Emmy just blatantly tells you the reason why that's not the case. As the nurse, he's just hinting that, yeah, it would never happen.
And Ren already kind of spoiled it anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's probably right outside the door going,
Hisao, would you keep it down already? We're getting ready for classes!
Hisao, I authorize you to go do something with that woman. It is your duty.
Nurse authorizes the use of love.
Nurse authorizes the use of your penis. Please use that full force and thrust. Harder. Where's Ren? I know that she's...
Wait a minute. There's only one way how she could have gotten better so soon. Yeah, I figured that was the case. Sometimes the easiest way to cure a cold is to give it to someone else.
Oh my.
Ooh.
I'm gonna probably go with the worst immune system, actually. Considering that Ren doesn't seem to really, how should I say, interact with things that much other than painting. So, usually those that have more introvert jobs and such. God damn. Yes, ma'am. Okay, yeah. Hisao, I get that, but why is your pants having a bulge doing that? Why?
Well, I don't know. Every time you yell, it just twitches a bit.
Well, that's just a disgrace of penises everywhere.
All of a sudden, she's spying on the ceiling again. God damn it, Hisao! We told you to take your damn medicine!
Oh, help her. Yeah, she'll be fine, you know.
It is Ren after all.
Wait, then that means that, considering that Ren gets better in the next route, fairy. Oh dear. That, I think, that could probably explain why Emmy's kind of, well, being part of the crowd is kind of in her own grouping, I guess?
Yeah, in a sense?
I am blue, if I were green, I would die. If I were green, I would die. If I were deep, I would die.
What was that band? Europop, I think it was?
Yep.
Thank you for that song?
Yeah, Eiffel 65, yeah.
Eiffel 65, there we go. Where did Europop come in?
That's what they generally called it, so...
Yeah.
I think that was like their Europop album, I think. Oh, I remember last night.
Oh, how could we forget?
You beat me over the head with a pillow, and then you started yelling something like, "Brother!" What the hell? When did you become Liquid Snake? It's one of those weird dreams. You're that, or you're a pirate. And then you were saying that you were going to sail to the Grand Line about 1,000 episodes later. You see how I almost do it all the time. Get over it.
Just put on your sunglasses. Deal with it.
Where are my sunglasses? Oh, wait, they're in the car. Fuck!
I don't have any sunglasses with me right now either, so damn.
Damn. A new anime coming soon. Pirate school. Hey, we did prison school, so why not?
Why not?
I totally would go for a pirate anime. Except they already kind of did something like that, except with ninjas, but with stupid.
Yes.
Believe it! Dude. Do you just like strawberries, or you really got some feral senses that you haven't been using?
Seriously.
I mean, strawberries are nice and all, but I'll be honest, I'm more of a fan of peaches.
Yeah.
But that's just me. Now the girls know what to do in order to pretty much make sure that I don't do anything except sit there and drool like an idiot.
Yeah.
Here's the peach. Wait, what's that guy doing? Oh. yeah, I'm staying away from him. He's a creep. Come on!
God damn it, Sal! Just kiss her already!
And then all suddenly somebody just appears and just goes, "Just do it!"
Shia LaBeouf is now just giving his motivational speech.
Right.
Just do it! Make your dreams come true and just do it!
Good motivator.
Long story short here, Shia LaBeouf just stole Nike's ad slogan for his motivational speech. And the whole make your dreams come true, that's so cliche, anyone can say it.
Fuck you! Fuck you, school bell! Fuck you!
You're ruining what was supposed to be a romantic moment!
Is that a date? That was there, I think. Wait. Oh, God! That further supports the theory. Well, I guess Emmy was kind of slightly on the medicine, and oh, Corinne. She took so much cold medicine. I think she was trying to forget.
Well, it's about goddamn time, Sal!
Jesus Christ! It took you all the way till the end of the second act, but you didn't even get that far?
I swear, if Mother Shizune was here, she probably would have done it in like a week!
On a chair! You're tied up! And me watching with the camera! And pulling out Pornhub! I'm gonna make sure I get 100 million hits this sound, whether you like or not! And then she just shakes her head, yes. As if it was all part of the master plan. Oh, fuck.
Oh, God.
All right, yeah, we went past it, but see you guys next
time. We'll see you for the start of Act 3.